Welcome back, gang. So now we are ready to start tackling our layout. The first thing that I want to do is to deal with this dashboard up here. I want to change this to our logo, and I want to add the username and a welcome, a little welcome section here. So how we're going to do that is head over to our code editor, our text editor, go down to resources, JS, and then go to the layouts folder and app layout. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is go ahead and cut out this div up here and the component, the banner component, because we're not going to be using that. Let's just slide this over to the left. And let's see, we can get rid of the component from here, the banner. Okay, and that's done. Now, the first thing I want to do is add some classes to this first div. So it's going to be flex call. Minimum screen we'll keep, and then we'll go ahead and get rid of this background because we're not going to be needing it. Okay, open that up. So now for this nav class, we're going to add a width of full. We're going to make it fixed, and we're going to give it a Z index of 20. Now I'm making it fixed because I want it to stay in place when we scroll down the page. So this way that the top nav will always be accessible. Okay. So the next one I want to do is change up this logo. We can keep the styling on the div. The inertia link we're going to keep to dashboard. We're going to add, we'll take this out, we don't need that. And we're going to add our classes to this. So it'll be height of 3/4 and a width of 16. And now in this, we're also going to add our image. Why don't I try? No, that's not good. Okay, we'll go image. The source, we put a colon in front of the source. And then for the actual tag, we'll put storage, images, logo, .png. And the alt is gonna be logo. Now if you're not sure about this or you're just joining us for the first time, this is now located in our storage folder, app folder, public folder, images, and there it is, logo. And close that up. Okay, great. So now we can leave this one alone. This is our dashboard. Let's take a quick look and see, make sure that took. Okay, there we go. And it goes back to our dashboard. Okay. So we can go ahead and keep this dashboard the way it is. We're going to go down to this stuff here. We can actually go ahead and get rid of this altogether because it's the Teams features. We'll open it up so you can take a look. This is all Teams feature stuff, and we've deactivated that since we're not going to be using Teams in this project. We'll get rid of that one. Okay. So now we have hidden, small flex, small item center, and then I want to add one more class here for small, and we'll call it justify end. Okay. And we have ML6, and then we're going to have width of path. Okay, great. So now for this class, ML3, we need to add flex item center, and that should be good for that. Okay, so now the drop down align right, that's good, that's good. This we need to change some of the classes in here, so I'm gonna just cut and paste a little bit of code to put in there. This way you don't have to watch me type all of it out. Copy. Okay, and then we're gonna add it right in here. Paste. Okay. And all that is just adding flex, some focus, and some of the other things that it has on it. Okay. So now the next thing I want to add is a template tags. We'll open that up. And for this one, we'll put the if page props user. Okay, and in that, if you remember, these are the props we have coming in from Inertia that's just grabbing it from the back end. So the first thing we want to put is a span tag, and our class that we're going to put on it is capitalize. I don't know why it's not working properly, but we'll just do it this way to be a little bit faster. Class, and then capitalize. Okay, and here we want to put welcome. So all that basically is just that if there's a logged in user, then they'll see welcome. And then the next line we're going to add to this is span with the class of ML1, margin left. And in here, we're gonna have some curly braces. And in the curly braces, we're gonna add page props user username. Okay, and let's just go ahead and take a look and make sure that that took. So refresh the page. And we should see it on this side, right here. Welcome test and the user. Okay, we'll fix that styling as well in a moment. We'll go ahead and add another span tag. And then class, or the else. And then the class will also be capitalized. Can I spell capitalize? Capitalize. And in the span tag, we're gonna put welcome user. Now, we don't really need to add this. The only reason I'm adding this is because I like to make sure that I have fallbacks for everything, just in the event that for whatever reason they were able to get in, that this is what they would see instead of just a made up user's name. It's just a personal preference, but that's how I tend to do things. Okay, so now we have our image class. We have height of 8, width of 8, rounded full. The only thing I need to add here is the margin left, right, to move it over a little bit because it was too close to the text. Okay. That's good, that's good. Button username. Now, the other thing that I want to change on here is instead of having this span tag here, I'm gonna get rid of that. We're gonna get rid of that, and the reason is because we're going to put the VLS on this button instead. Okay, we can add it down here. And it'll be V if or sorry, the else. And then again, I'm going to copy and paste some the classes for this, because it'll just be much easier than going through one by one. Copy, paste. Ooh, wrong one. Let's try it again. Sorry, I have a new mouse and it's a bit tricky to work. Okay, highlight that and paste it in. Great. Okay, so now I want to take this button, this VLSE, we have a class on it. We're going to open this up and put, we're going to put this in a div. Okay. Move that up. And instead of username or user.name, we're going to have username. Okay. Bring that up. And then this icon we can just keep. This comes standard with the installation. We need to change this one to button. Okay, so let's just take a look and make sure we didn't break anything. I do this a lot because I do tend to break stuff very easily. So we want to make sure that this is moved over. Okay, cool. One thing I do want to put is welcome user. I want to add after this one, I want to put a space and an exclamation point like we have on this one. Okay, so now that's done. So now this information here is actually coming from this refresh that, so we can see it clearly. Okay, so when you go down to this, this is what the next line of code is. That's this stuff here, manage account, profile show. We can go ahead and knock out API tokens because we're not going to be using that. The border gray can stay, logout button can stay, hamburger can stay. Okay, now this stuff here is from, if we were to open this up real quick, and let's say we shrink the screen, when we click on the hamburger, it's this stuff here. This is the minimized stuff. Okay, so again, let's take out what we don't need, which is we need the username, email. We don't need the API tokens. We'll keep the logout. We'll take out the Teams features because we're not using any of that. And that's pretty much it. Now, if you take a look at this, we're not going to be using this. We're gonna change this up as well. But for now, we can just go ahead and take it out. We're going to be doing something else differently. As a matter of fact, we're going to be making, if you watch the first video, with the layout of everything that we'll be doing, you'll remember that we have a sidebar here. We're not going to do that in this video, but we are laying the foundation, the groundwork to get to that. Okay, so again, we won't need that. Matter of fact, I'll just set up the some of the styling for it. So it'll be a class div. I don't know why my Emmet's not working with me, or Vitor, whichever one it is that's causing a problem, but class equals, for now we'll just put flex flex wrap pt dash 16. And for the small screens, it's going to be a flex no wrap. And here we're going to have, I'll just copy this just so that we remember what it's going to be. It'll be a page sidebar. Just as a note for when we get there, we'll be getting to the rest of this main slot. For right now, I just want to handle the sidebars and the navigation bars. So now we can scroll down and get rid of this application mark because we're not using it, and this jet application mark again we're not using. Let's see, scroll down a little more. Okay, we don't need this method since we're not going to be using it, and that's pretty much it. So let's make sure that we didn't break anything. Refresh. Okay, so that got rid of that extra little space there. And when we scroll down, our z-index, our fixed navbar is now working properly. Everything's pointing to the right place. Okay, great. Thanks for watching, guys. I think I'm done for today. I will push this up to GitHub. And thanks for watching. See you next time.